Bringing news from the State House of the nation's capital to you. Welcome to On the Record. I'm Matt Sheehan. For the first segment of On the Record, I'm joined live by Congressman Darren LaHood. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Matt. Good to be with you and your viewers today.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, first, I wanted to talk to you about the presidential election. President Trump still refusing to concede to Mr. Biden. I kind of got a two-part question here for you. Do you believe the president should concede, and do you now consider Joe Biden as the president-elect?
Well, Matt, first of all, as you know, I've been a strong supporter of the president. I was his co-chair in Illinois on his re-election. And I've been willing to give the president the benefit of the doubt. We're now about, it'll be 3 weeks tomorrow from the election. But I'm also a supporter of evidence and facts. And if there is evidence of improprieties or voting irregularities, those should be examined. Remember, with our democracy, the cornerstone of our democracy is the integrity of it. And if those issues are there, they need to be looked at. Now, 3 weeks has gone by. The president has filed many lawsuits. Most of those have been dismissed. And so there is becoming a point where those legal remedies are running out, and the president's path to any type of victory is really narrowing. And so I think this week becomes important for the president to step up and acknowledge where any of those improprieties are at. And if those facts and evidence aren't there, we need to make that transition to supporting which is arguably the next president, Vice President Biden. I have been supportive of the Vice President Biden getting intelligence briefings. I think that's important for the continuity of this country. But again, once these legal remedies are over with, the country needs to move on.
Sure. Well, hey, Republicans gained a few seats in the U.S. House of Representatives. The Senate still up in the air because of what's going on in Georgia. How do you think lawmakers can join forces in a bipartisan way to bring the country, which right now many think is very polarized, together?
Well, there's no doubt if you look at the election, we are a divided country. But the election is over with now, and I think the American people want us to get together and work on issues that affect them. We should be working on a next stimulus relief package to help small businesses, whether it's companies like Peoria Charter Coach or our restaurants, or the people that work in the banquet facility, industry, or the travel industry. So now is the time to come together. The election is over with. We know what the House and the Senate are gonna look like. We picked up a lot of seats in the House, which was unexpected. And now we need to work together. And I hope we can do that in the lame duck session, first and foremost, to bring relief to the American people as it relates to coronavirus.
Well, that's a great transition here. So let's talk about a COVID-19 relief package. Now that the election is over, when can we expect something to get passed?
Well, we get back to D.C. next Monday. I don't think we should leave D.C. until we get something done. We have an obligation and responsibility to help people. And again, election's over. It was, a fierce battle in many ways. We talked about a lot of different ideas, but now it's time to, again, find collaboration. And that's what I look forward to doing when we get back next week. And our goal should be between now and Christmas, coming up with another relief package to help those small businesses that are still hurting out there and get people through those winter months. And I worry about disproportionately affected businesses, restaurants, people that are in the banquet industry or hospitality or travel. Those are the ones that are really hurting now, and so I hope we can do that.
And real quickly before we leave, are there any bills or legislation you want people to know about that you're working on?
Well, we're working on a bill called the CERTS Act, which would help our motor coach industry, help companies like Peoria Charter Coach that have been around for over 100 years. I'm also working on a bill called the Clean Start Act, which would help with cleaning and PPE and those issues related to the expense of that. Those are two bills in a bipartisan way we're trying to get passed, and I hope to do that in December here.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Mr. LaHood. This full interview will be shared and posted on our website.